Hey there, this is Agent 355, and I am doing Desktop Dungeons today. This is going to be an intro video, so I am all my lonesome, because it's going to be relatively short. Desktop Dungeons is a puzzle game. It has some roguelike elements, namely that you kill monsters, gather up loot, and level up, but it's primarily a puzzle game, and you'll see what I mean once it gets going. This little bit right here is the closest thing we have to a story. Basically, you come across an abandoned kingdom, and you end up gathering money by killing monsters and rebuilding a kingdom. And it works out pretty well for obvious reasons. In the game itself, you have your stats, you have strength and attack and all that sort of stuff. It's fairly simple, you know. There are no dice rolls. If you have 5 strength, you do 5 damage. It's just that simple. Attack combat is pretty easy. You just click on the enemy. You can see that everything is preordained, how it's going to work out. You can see what it's going to be before you even click, because it's pretty important to know. Exploring refills your health. Exploring is also typically how you find what the hell is going on. So too much exploring without any killing will deplete your healing reserves, because every map, the number of map squares are limited, and every one you explore that doesn't heal you is a wasted space. Right now, looking at the meat man, you can see that he would kill me, and so I can't take him on right now. Those little tick marks are showing you how much damage each shot would take. So while he could kill me in 3 hits, but it would take me close to 7 to kill him. This being the tutorial, you can't really mess everything up, because it tells you exactly what to do as you walk around. It's also rather critical of you, which is fun. When you level up, you refill your life and your mana. Leveling up when you really need that life is a very good idea, because it saves that much healing. If you can get a full heal just from killing a monster, then don't explore rooms. As you go around the normal dungeons, you'll often run into monsters that are considerably higher level than you. That should just be avoided. Monsters are not aggressive. They will not move. They will not chase you. They just sit there. If you hit a monster and then are forced to run away, they still don't chase you. They'll just sit there. That's because this is not a true roguelike, in that you aren't actively running away in your life for fear all the time. Whether you win or lose the dungeon, you get the results page, which shows you what monsters you killed, at what level, and what your loot was worth when you left, or if you managed to take out any loot at all. As the tutorial moves onward, the story progresses. It's a pretty standard story. It's fun and interesting. I think one of the things this game really has going for it is the art style. I just love even the monsters, and the character art is just amazing. Also in the dungeons are power-ups. They are represented by little tiles with symbols on them. The symbols, of course, match your stats over there in bar form on the right. The attack raises your damage by 10%. So, and that is cumulative and resets every time you level. So grab those power-ups as soon as you see them. There's no reason to save them for later. You just grab them as soon as you can. Of course, the heart power-ups raise your HP, and there are mana power-ups that raise your MP. Also notice that monsters have things like physical resistance. That blob, underneath his name, has physical resist 50%. So while I have 6 attack, and I would normally do 6 damage, I only do 3 because of the physical resistance. And here we see the mana increases. I think the developers find goats innately funny, which is why they're used quite often. To be fair, goats are innately funny, unless you look at those eyes. Those hideous rectangle eyes, those things are frightening. So there, now we have our first view of the kingdom. It's pretty small right now, with only some huts and an outpost, but it will grow. One of the nice things about this game is as you progress, you unlock more things and more complex things, so your game gets progressively more difficult and more fun as you continue. For right now, we only got huts and an outpost, though. That will allow us to create humans and guards. When you start, to start a dungeon, of course you just hit start dungeon. You'll select the dungeon you're going to go to. You'll select your race and your class. In this case, as I said, you only get humans from the huts, and the outpost gives you guards, which have no special abilities. You can also grab preparations, but we don't have any preparations right now because, well, it's the beginning of the game. It's a tutorial. Now, in addition to runes that increase your stats, you can also find spells. This Burn to Rise spell is a fireball. It's pretty standard. It tells you what damage it deals right over on the right. Costs 6 mana, deals 4 damage. That will go up as you level. Notice that when you attack an enemy with spells, they can't attack back, so that blob never even got a chance. Mana is refilled when you move, just like health. So if you're in need of mana, then it might be a good time to do some exploring. Hit tab to switch back and forth. Sometimes if you're standing on special spaces, you won't be able to see your inventory, but you can get to it. You just have to hit tab. And that's it. That was the grand magic tutorial. We're rewarded with all of this goodies. So we're going to pick this up and we're going to take off. Now there are sometimes these little side dungeons and they sometimes hold bonus stuff. And looks like that one was trapped and the dungeon changed. The side dungeons are typically puzzles. There's typically something to find, and you have to solve what it is. Some dungeons are very simple and don't have any puzzle elements, and some dungeons will actually unlock things like new altars and new dungeon features for you and the rest of the levels that you play. Now this guy, he has magical resistance, and if we just try to attack him, he will just kill us. So by converting our fireball spell, we gain bonus attack. Humans gain bonus attack when converting items and spells. With that extra attack, we do just enough to win the battle. And we're free to leave the dungeon. Now, as you progress through the game, you'll unlock other races and other classes. Classes typically change your innate abilities, while races will change what bonus you get with conversion points. For right now, we get to have just enough money to upgrade our outpost to a guard, to the next level. It costs 150 gold, which is conveniently just as much as we have, so our outpost became a guild. Now that we have a guild, we can summon fighters. Fighters actually start with some skills. So it's a little bit closer to what a real game would look like now, but we're still in the tutorial for a few more minutes. Notice that fighters, there will be a description of all the classes, of course, in the post, but for right now, fighters are pretty simple. They start with the easiest skills, by which I mean they start with a level of death protection, they see all the monsters on the map, it's a very easy class. It's a very straightforward class and doesn't take a whole lot of lateral thinking. Now, just like spells, you can find weapons in the dungeon. This one increases my damage by 2. And shields, which reduces all my damage by 2. Now it says here, if you read this thing, that you can only hold 3 physical and magical items. So, for instance, my 3 physical traits would be those 3 items I have equipped. But that's a lie. I think that was in a previous patch, and I never took out the thing. Because when I pick up this pendant of mana, it gives me its effect anyway, so that would be 4 physical items I have equipped. So, I'm not quite sure what it's talking about. I think that was in an older build. We've also got health potions, which function exactly how you might imagine. So here I am up against a level 3 goat, and you're forced to use all of your things at your disposal. First thing you want to do is use all your mana to throw fireballs on him. He will still kill me in a straight fight. However, if I convert my fireball, because I can't use it anymore anyway, and I was thinking about what else one convert, and I could hit him once, and if I hit him again, notice how it says next hit, barely alive? That is because death protection will let you take a hit that would normally kill you once. So you can survive that one extra hit, which sometimes will make the difference. And used well makes a really big difference. In this case, again, it's just the one enemy. Notice now that we have a lot more options available in the town. We have a guild, a thief den, a church, and these are all to unlock additional classes. We also have 200 gold, so we have a decision to make here in a minute. But first, somebody comes up and talks to us about taxidermy. Boss monsters in each dungeon will drop a trophy. Trophies are worth gold. That's your primary source of income, because killing the little monsters is not worth nearly as much as killing the big monsters. Now, as you kill the big monsters, there is inflation. For instance, if you kill the exact same boss over and over, all the other trophies will become worth more money, and the trophy you keep killing will not be worth as much. You can see the list of all the possible monies right here. And, most of them we don't have yet, but it's pretty interesting. It's a good fun way to get money, is to go out and kill monsters. The tavern's where you get quests. You see the quests are listed to the right. City expansion is basically to clear out the three easy dungeons, which are pretty straightforward and simple. We'll be going to one of those next time, but those are actual dungeons, and so no time for that right now. Now, as far as the guild and the thief den go, we have a decision to make. We can't afford to upgrade the guild yet, but we can afford to upgrade one of the other three. Now, eventually, each building will allow you to unlock three different classes, but we'll only get the first with the first upgrade. In this case, we would get the thief. Or, if we wanted to go and upgrade the church, we could get the priest. And if we didn't want to upgrade the priest and instead wanted to go to the mage tower, we could get the wizard. So I'm going to let the thread decide on which one they want to see first, and we will resume next episode.